Before you start importing users to Qlik NPrinting, you must create an Excel file using the import syntax as explained in the Qlik help documentation. First, you have to add the filter worksheet. To import filters, you must specify the name of the filter and optionally a description. You must add the name of the app associated with filters, and the app must exist on the server. Set the enabled field to true if you want to create an active filter. Then you have to define the name of the connection. By specifying this, you can separate filters based on identically named fields from different connections in the same app. The connection must exist on the server. In the values field, you can filter string values. You have to list them in this form, the field name, and then the name of the values separated with a comma. You can use the numeric values field to filter by specific values. In this example, we filter the category ID by these values. You can add formulas to calculate values to filter by using Qlik View formulas. You can use the advanced search to filter values by using Qlik View or Qlik Sense advanced search expressions. The user worksheet must include the following fields. The email is the user unique email address and it will be used to log in. The username is the unique username that is displayed in the interface to identify the user. Please note, if you import a user with the same name as an existing user, the import will overwrite the existing user. In the password field, use the password that the user uses to log into Qlik NPrinting. The unique domain account assigned to the user is an optional field, but is required if the users have to receive reports in Qlik Sense Hub or if the users have to create on-demand reports in Qlik View. In the enabled field, you have to set it to true if you want to create an active user. The time zone is scheduled according to the time zone of the user. You must type the name as it appears in the Qlik NPrinting interface. In the locale field, you set the display language of Qlik NPrinting. Then you have a series of fields that you can fill in to add more details to the users, such as description, nickname, user's title, company, job title, department, and office. In folder and subfolder, you can add a report destination folder or subfolder that the user can access. In read and write password, you can add a password needed to open or edit the report. Credential authentication will be disabled for the user if no password is specified. In filters, you can add the list of filters the user can access separated by commas. In groups, you add the list of groups the user is a member of separated by commas. In roles, you add the list of the user's security roles separated by commas. To add the user to a group, you have to define the name of the group, optionally add a description, and you must set the enabled field to true if you want to create an active group. Before you create the import task, be sure that the apps and the connections that you refer to in the Excel file exist in Qlik NPrinting. To create an import task, select Tasks and then select Import Task. Qlik the Create Import Task button. Give the import task a name, Qlik on the Add Source button, and then select Import from Excel. Then, add the path to the location where the Excel file that we have prepared previously is stored. Then check the option you want to include for this task. In this case, we are going to select all the options. When done, Qlik on Create. Now you have the option to run the task manually or to run a test before you start importing. In this case, we will test the import task before running or scheduling it. When the test is complete, you can download the log file and check the details. When you are sure that everything is working properly, you can run the task. As you can see, here you have the filters that have been created. You can also see that the users and groups that we had in the Excel file are now created in Qlik NPrinting. When done, you can create a trigger to schedule an update of the users. In this case, we are going to create a weekly import users task. So, for example, we are going to select Friday so the import task will be launched every Friday at the time you set. You can then modify the frequency, the time zone, and the start and end date. When done, click on Create to save the changes. And here you have the trigger you just created. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.